doing their best to ensure that this Congress has to take a So, the issues of this campaign, to my mind, are really three. The first one is the economic issue. The banking crisis of 2008-2009 was not caused by the greed of social care workers, bus drivers, street cleaners, or any of those people. They're not the ones. They're not the ones who evade tax and put their savings in offshore bank accounts. They're not the ones who invest in the subprime or crisis in the USA. The banking crisis was caused by lack of regulation of the banks, and all those issues that go with it. And so the initial response of the government in that time to take the banks into public ownership was the right thing to do. I was okay about that. The problem was that they weren't really taken into public ownership. There was shares bought in them, there was capital injected in them, there was quantitative easing injected into what they did by a massive amount. But it was not the same as public ownership of those banks. Those banks weren't directed to cut the excessive pay of executives and the bonuses that they got. They weren't directed to invest in manufacturing industry and infrastructure. They were to carry on much as before. And so I find it very strange when I'm writing to publicly owned banks saying, will they please give a loan to somebody that's starting a small enterprise and things like this. They would rather give their money into yet more house price inflation. So I think we missed a very big trick there by not properly controlling those banks. Then we went into the situation more deeply, and the narrative was that the debt was too big, the loans were too many, and therefore the way to deal with it was to cut public expenditure. Of course, once you start cutting public expenditure, you start making people redundant. When you make people redundant from public sector work, they end up often working on worse conditions for longer hours, on lower pay, with worse pensions. Therefore, they are worse off. The state is worse off because they get less in taxation from them. It's actually a downward spiral, which is of no help to anybody. And so the cuts get deeper and deeper. And that economic strategy actually doesn't do anything in the long run, except allow those in the finance industry, possibly, to make a great deal of money, damage the life chances of a very large number of other people, lead to huge cuts in public expenditure, lead to problems in local government and in health and every other area, and a deeply adult social care crisis in Britain. And so I think we have to challenge the whole austerity agenda and that which goes with it. What the government has done this week, or last week, in the budget, first of all, George Osborne and Cameron seem to have a real problem with young people. They want to take away the allowances for the third and subsequent children in any large family, which seems to me to be something deeply odious about that. Surely every child matters. Every child should be protected. And they also want to take away the remaining, and they are the remaining, grant facilities, maintenance grant facilities for children of poorer families going to university and turn those into loans. We already have now a whole generation of young people leaving university with massive debts. We're now going to extend that even further. Is it really right that we've allowed the student fee basis to become the financial basis of universities rather than public funding of it? And when people tell me, well, actually, you can't ever get rid of fees because it's necessary, I put it this way. If somebody becomes a very good engineer that comes out of university, or a very good doctor that comes out of university, if they become a good engineer and a good doctor, we all benefit from that. We travel on a safer train because a good engineer designed it. We're in a safer building because there was a good architect. We're better in our health because there's a good doctor. Education isn't just about individual gain and individual advancement. It's about the advancement of society as a whole. look at it in that way. And so the next part of the Tory agenda is the welfare reform bill, so-called, this week. Now, I was beyond disgusted at the way in which welfare benefits have been basically attacked.